Hi there. I'm Amy Van Dyke. I'm one of the curators at Museum of the Bible. And lately, I've been wondering how the Israelites made clothing and blankets out of wool. So I thought we should go talk to my first century friend, Shoshana. She knows way more about this than I do. So let's go talk to her.
Now, before you can start weaving, and once you've spun your wool, you have to set up a loom. Now, being in a Gentile's home, I didn't have a loom of my own, but I found a very interesting loom that they have here. It's made of metal. I've never used a metal loom before, but I'm sure it'll work fine. This is a linen strand. It's a bit thinner than wool. It's made from flax. I tied it up here. Perhaps it's just easier if I show it to you. So, as I said, this is one continuous strand of linen. I'll bring it up to the top. I've decided that I'm going to go around the back of the top one first. It doesn't matter which direction you go, just choose one and stay the same way on the entire side. Then I'm going to bring the ball over. You want to make sure that these lines stay taut as you're doing it. I'd encourage you to try this from your home as well. It's not very difficult, it just takes a little bit of practice. So I'm going to take this and put it on the outside of the strand, the outside of this strand, in between the two that I've already made. Then I want to think about looping it around itself. So and I want to mirror on both sides. So see how I've put it on the outside of this strand? I'm going to then go back over the same way I came, through, and then if you can see here, we are perfectly mirrored. Both of the up and down strands are in between the two loops right here. So then I'll just try to make sure that it's nice and taut, and we'll pull it all the way until it's nice and tight. Then we'll come down here. We'll do the same thing. You bring it on the outside, loop it around, bring it back over. See how I'm holding the loop here? Bring it back under and through. And then try to pull it taut. Now, once I'm finished setting up the basic skeleton of my mat or whatever I'm about to weave, I just tie it off at the end here. I didn't make mine very big because I don't have much wool and, I just can't make much here without being in Nazareth in my hometown. So I'm just making it this size. I would encourage you to make one at your home, and you can make it whatever size you like, but starting small is good. So the next step is going to be take your long strand of wool, our spun wool, and we're going to tie it over on this post here. I'm going to tie it nice and tight. This is going to be to keep the wool up and nice and taut while you're weaving it. So we'll finish tying it off like this. Now we're going to do an over-under pattern. And you can see how I do it here. I'm going to start by going over. It doesn't matter which one you start doing. But I'll start by going over. And then I'll go under the next one, around back. It's like you're zigzagging between. I've heard Gentiles use this term, zigzagging. Zigzagging between. Just make sure you stay consistent. So I have to go over the next one, under the next one, and I'll just keep doing this over and over and over. And here we are at the end of our first strand. So we're going to take this and push it all the way up. Usually I'd have a sort of a stick that I would use to push these all the way up to the top, as you can see, nice and tight. Then, if I started over this end strand, I have to go under it. And I'll do the same pattern coming back. While weaving is very tedious, it's also very soothing. I would encourage you to do it while you're, what did they call it? Netflix and chill? Whatever that means. Try this and see how you do. And if you do well, I've been told you should tag the Museum of the Bible in a picture. Again, I don't know all of these Gentile phrases, but try it and see what happens. Now, I'm going to finish making this mat for little Ishmael here. Shalom, my friends.
Dad!